guest inherited the most famous ears in science fiction and made them, ladies and gentlemen, his own.
Absolutely.
It's only logical then that we give him the biggest welcome the Brekkie Bridge is capable of. Please set applause to Stan. Star Trek Voyager's Tuvok, which I keep getting wrong, actor Tim Roth. Exactly. Live long and prosper, sir.
I love that. I think that that's one of the nicest greetings, live long and prosper.
I think it's great.
I know it's a big thing in you know, it's Vulcan, it's normal. But for us here on Earth, we love that.
Yeah, we do. Welcome. Now, many people may not recognise you as you are, although I doubt that very much. So let's see a clip of you as Lieutenant Tuvok.
I'm Commander Tuvok of the Starship Voyager. Tuvok.
Tuvok.
Yes. And you?
Nos.
We'll go to my vessel.
The 12th Sector.
I love that.
Now, many people may not recognise you out of your makeup, so let's see. Sorry. You've been in Star Trek Voyager for 5 years. Do you ever get fed up of playing an alien with pointy ears?
Not at all.
No.
As long as there's still work involved, I'll put them on all day long. Not a problem at all. It's not the makeup process, really. It's just the hours. They tend to be rather long and unpredictable. So it's other than that, it's a kick. The guys I work with are a lot of fun, and we cut up probably more than the directors would like to see.
Okay. So, do people flick your ears?
From time to time, yes, they do. But it doesn't hurt. It's okay. Okay.
How long does it take for your makeup in the morning? How long does it
not long. It's about 20 minutes.
Just 20 minutes?
Oh, 20 it takes me longer.
it's down and dirty. These guys are great. They're fast.
That's amazing. 20 minutes. I thought to do the full Vulcan job.
No,
2 hours every day, Johnny.
No, the heavier prosthetics, the guys that have the full makeup on, and sometimes they're like pieces that they're put on their face all the way around. Those are about 2.5 hours.
Wow, every time they do.
I'll put it on the screen, Captain.
Because I'd love to do Star Trek, but it would be the makeup process after 3 months on board the bridge.
I hope, with all my heart, you get a part in Star Trek.
It would be my
dream. You'd reach your destiny, wouldn't you?
Oh,
wow. You'd
but
be brilliant at it as well.
I won't get the chance now because it's stopping, isn't it?
No, we've got another year left.
Oh, Tim, please tell them. Please tell them. Lisa, she's finishing here in August. Please tell them that. Can you really make her...
Can you imagine, Tim, all in one jumpsuit in a sort of blue-black with a zip from right under through up there. I might need some careful lighting, but by God, you'd believe I was an alien.
Oh, please have a word to
talk to them. Would that be with or without prosthetics?
Well, I wouldn't need them. I'd bring my own beard.
The good Lord has blessed her with prosthetics.
No, Lisa, please, Tim. Really put words.
That's what I want. That, a rose named after me in a pub.
Oh. Please see if you can sort that out.
I see, I put in a word.
No, but really, don't just say that because you're on a show, but actually do something about it.
Sure.
No, I mean it.
Sure.
Do you think that you might have a break in a year from it?
Yes.
But do you think that ultimately it will come back because it's such a winning formula, Star Trek?
I think it will definitely come back. You know, Paramount, it's been around for 30 years, this show. I think any other studio would give their eye tooth to have at least a show that's got that kind of history behind it and recognizable name. I mean, all over the world. I was in a Blockbuster Video. I kid you not. This is in L.A. And first of all, to be in a Blockbuster Video, to see this character in the begin with is very strange. It was a Maasai warrior from Tanzania. He was in full Maasai dress.
Fantastic.
Okay, tattoos from head to toe. Yeah.
We're familiar with the
light. He had plates in his bottom lip that were about that big around. And his ears had the rings in them, stretched all the way down to here.
Whoa. That always looks
all right, this is in the video store. He's just
minding
browsing.
His own business.
Okay, right.
Browsing.
And I'm looking over here and I just like a double take, whoa. And then all of a sudden he looks at me and he says, "We watch your show in Tanzania. Star Trek, yes." In a perfect British accent. I just stood there, that's great. It was just a most amazing encounter. I mean, all over the world.
Did he say, you look so weird?
It's so bizarre.
Change that story. Okay.
A lot of the stars get a chance to direct the show as well.
Yes, we do. I've had an opportunity to direct about a season and a half ago. It was called Living Witness. It was a very good episode. Very
remember
strong.
It?
I don't know that. I do know
I
that.
Like Voyager. Which is, Voyager the one with six or seven in it?
Yeah.
Seven
or nine. Not round
six
my house.
Six of seven.
It's early. Three of five.
Yeah, six of nine.
But what was it like directing? Does it mean that you can't be in the episode that much? I can't remember that one.
Yeah, they try to write you really light in those episodes.
Yeah.
And quite frankly, if you're directing, it's just a distraction. You have to go in front of the camera from time to time. So I try to isolate the character myself so that I'm not in the major part of the scene. Just keep it separate so I can just pop those easily.
The editing's very good in Star Trek and always has been.
Oh, it's
intense.
So well put together.
Intense,
I just
yes.
like the shh.
Oh, if in doubt.
I'd love to have that in my house on every door.
Yeah, but it's not so much fun when you're walking towards them and they don't go. Instead, you go bang because they forgot to open them. You know.
Do not give away secrets. It really annoys me with that. Do you know what? Your character in the show, being a Vulcan.
Yes.
I say, Klingons have evolved a lot since 1972, haven't they?
They've changed a little bit, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Being a Vulcan has rather limited emotional range. Now, we've seen from your performance on stage,
yes.
I've seen that because I've seen a video of you with your band that you're over here touring with, that you definitely enjoy letting your hair down, so to speak.
From time to time.
From time to time. So we're going to give you the opportunity to inject some more feeling into your character in an exercise we've called...
Fill me up, Scotty.
Mike's ruled that out. What we'd like you to do is recreate some of the lines from your scenes, but using some feeling.
All right.
Instead of the cold logic of the Vulcan. First, we'll show you a clip, and then we want you to give us the line again, but this time with some emotional baggage, chosen at random from this sack of emotions! Yay!
Sack!
Bring forth the sack. Bring forth the sack. Okay, here we go. Here's clip one. Have a look.
All right.
According to that formula, 30 minutes would translate to 2 days, 11 hours, and 47 seconds.
Hello.
Can you remember that line? Okay, I'm going to pick out an emotion from the sack of emotion. Can you remember the line?
I'm going to do my best.
Okay.
That's what I do. I get paid to remember my lines.
Okay.
You're good.
What's that? What does it say? Trying to stop laughing. Okay,
right.
Nice one. Okay, so let's do
it. Camera one.
Okay, to camera one.
According to that formula, 30 seconds would translate to 2 days, 11 hours, and 47 seconds.
I saw Lisa's little face. You loved that, didn't you?
Yeah. Right, let's have the next one.
Oh, I can play this all day. Here we go, let's go.
You feel nothing for me?
I told you. I don't experience emotion. I have developed an appreciation and respect for you. Nothing more.
Cold. Oh, blooming Vulcans. I've obviously been out.
There's nothing wrong with a bit of stoicism. Here you go. Good line to say if you just don't fancy someone, actually, isn't it?
Yeah. I have developed.
Yeah, I've developed a respect for you. But lust is beyond my ken.
Anger, okay. Oh. Ready?
Yeah.
Look, I told you! I don't experience emotion. I have developed an appreciation and respect for you. Nothing more!
Wow! I believe you!
Also, I sense Tim's, this is a real let out for Tim.
Yeah, he was on at the borderline.
He's felt like our voice shouting in the wilderness, and at last he's given voice to some of his fears. Okay, let's see the next one. We've got another one.
Yes!
Yeah! Yeah! Oh, there's only about five of them on the floor this morning, but my God, they sound like an army, don't they?
Hey!
Good. Okay, here we go. Here's the next one.
I see you've already been there.
Okay, and the emotion that can express into the sack of emotion. What's it going to be? There's a lot of excitement.
All right, in pain.
In pain.
In pain.
In pain.
There we go.
Mm.
Okay.
Hard.
We'll go to my vessel. I see you've already been there.
Watching.
Tim Ross!
Tim Ross.
Oh,
it when Vulcans let it out. They let it out on the Big Breakfast.
Yeah, they do.
We're back in a couple of seconds. Do not go away.
Yes.
Something missing.
Zara, don't do-